It's evangelism aimed at an audience that preachers may not be reaching.
We have to win this young hip-hop generation for Jesus Christ, and what we use is hip-hop music.
Our music needs to change.
Somebody doesn't want to be a player. Somebody don't want to be a thug. Somebody wants to live right. See ya!
Help us reach a lost generation before it's too late.
The title of my message today is Better or Bitter? The choice is yours. You can let each event that comes into your life make you bitter, or you can let it make you better. Because I'm telling you right now, there is nobody that can preach a message to you that's going to be able to tell you how you can avoid all the rude, obnoxious people in the world. Nobody can preach a message to you that's going to keep you from having an opportunity to be offended. You probably have at least 50 opportunities every 7 days to be offended. Did you hear me? And you keep hoping everybody will change. Well, they're not going to change. Come on, hear me loud and clear this morning. They're not going to change. You know who's going to change? You're going to change. You're going to change, and you're going to get so mature in Christ that they can't bother you. That is victory. Right in the midst of all of these things, we are more than conquerors. Not when all these things go away, we're more than conquerors, but right in the midst of them, we are more than conquerors. And you might as well just figure every time you decide to get in a relationship, that person is not going to perfectly meet your needs and perfectly make you happy all the time. I don't care who it is. Neighbor, friend, spouse, child. The closer you get to people, the more intimate you become, the more you find out about them, the more you're going to have to walk in unconditional love. We think when we walk away from a problem physically, then we no longer have the problem. But let me tell you, you can walk away from a problem and have it in you. So we stay busy as Christians. I mean, we're just working our heads off. Got to get rid of this temper. Be more patient. Be nicer. Submissive. Walk in love. What's wrong with me, God? No matter what I do, I still have a problem. I deal with one thing and another thing comes up. Part of being a right leader is getting to the bottom of the issues in your own life. And don't stay so busy that you never take time to deal with your own stuff. Come on now. I think we need to go deeper in this day and hour, not just live on the surface of everything. Why can't I control my temper? Why am I so impatient every time I don't get my way? Is it just the flesh? Maybe. Then deal with it. Read everything you can get your hands on about the crucifixion of the flesh. Find out how to die to self. Find out what spiritual maturity is. Let God deal with you. Beg Him to deal with you. Beg Him to put every obstacle in your way until every bit of your flesh is broken and crushed and liquefied and destroyed. Break me, God, break me. Bend my stubborn will. So I'm afraid to pray like that. Well, then you know what? You'll just keep wandering around in the wilderness all your life. You'll never make it to the promised land. Because if you don't want to be chastised and dealt with, if you don't learn how to love chastisement, a lot of the things that you think right now are your enemy, someday you'll find out they were indeed your best friend. Because those problems are what drove you to God. We start out dealing with relationships one way, and by the time God's done with us, we can deal with people the way Jesus did if we will let Him do the work in us. You can go from it being almost impossible to forgive to being quick to forgive. And for it just being the most natural thing to do when somebody comes against you, just, I forgive you, I ain't got no time for that stuff. God will take care of it. Take it up with God. Not my problem. I know who I am in Christ, what you think's between you and God. Learn how to endure injustice and trust God to make it right. You're going to have to learn how to do the right thing for a long time before the right thing starts happening to you. You're going to have to learn in relationships how to treat somebody right that has maybe never treated you right, maybe for a long time, and then God will bring a reward. If not from that person, from somebody, but you'll get your reward. You can't do somebody else's part, but you are responsible to do your part. Am I talking about just laying down and letting somebody abuse you? No, I'm not talking about, you know, letting somebody beat on you every day or sexually abuse. That's not what I'm talking about. But I'm talking majorly here today about all the silly, petty, goofy stuff. The defense mode that we go into. And I'll tell you one thing you're going to have to get delivered from, and that is reputation. Because you just cannot do the will of God if you are going to be concerned about your reputation. Not your family, not even within your family. Because I'm going to tell you something, if you're going to be a sold out, on fire believer in the Lord Jesus Christ, even your own family members will turn against you. You'll lose friends. You'll be called a fanatic. But if you'll just hold steady, the day will come when many of those people who judge and criticize you will come to you. They will come to you for help, advice, prayer. Be smart enough not to keep hurting yourself after somebody else has hurt you. You only hurt yourself when you stay bitter.
This is Cheryl. I'm in Denver, and God has just blessed you. Thank you so much.
This is Joshua. Oh, my goodness, you blessed me with that broadcast. You don't know how you blessed me. And this is something you can battle the world with, man. I showed it to one of the pastors. They love you.
My name is Bruce. I just want to say thank you, sir. I really love these sermon songs. I have Volume 1, you know, Pastor Jones and Creflo and all them. Basically, man, I just want to tell you that this has been a blessing in my life.
I know sermon songs and life radio and all that stuff is bumping, and you getting your pub. But, man, it was a watch the way you come out here to the West Coast. For real.